Too much or too little, clean or unsafe, water is one of the biggest challenges we face. And it's clear that our future depends on how we care for this precious resource. This exhibition, Water Pressure, is about bringing together ideas from design, art, activism and science that show how we could shape a more sustainable water culture. Already, 40% of the world faces water scarcity to varying degrees, and that's going to get much, much worse with human-induced climate change. But the global water crisis is largely man-made, down to our abuse and mismanagement of water and our massive overconsumption. It's clear to me that many of the ways we manage, value and use water need to be rethought, and that's where design comes in. This exhibition brings together ideas from around the globe that show how we could think about water differently and design a different future. The opening room, Water Stories, is a rich collection of ideas and objects from different eras and cultures that illuminate some of the rich mythology around water. Here we see a fantastic collection of vessels for storing and carrying drinking water. You'll see that there are shells, coconuts, clay vessels. It shows some of the richness of objects that we used for water before we got addicted to the toxic plastic bottle. Framing the room is this wonderful drawing by artist and activist Mariticha Pottridge. She calls for a new era when water and the river is perceived as a living being. We're not owners of water, but caretakers of water and nature. There are also powerful contemporary stories about water injustice. This series of photographs by Latoya Ruby Frazier documents the water crisis in Flint, Michigan in 2014. I think it began in 2014. Through municipal cost cutting caused the contamination of lead in the water and poisoned the mainly black community. Water is recognized as a human right, yet still 2 billion people lack access to safe drinking water and 1.5 billion to safe sanitation. Sanitation is one of the biggest challenges we face. It makes absolutely no sense that we use water to flush away human waste. There is a campaign called Death to the Flushing Toilet that proposes we do away with the flush and instead look at circular systems for capturing the nutrients from human waste for use in fertilizer. Here we have products that separate urine and feces for reuse as a liquid fertilizer for plants and vegetables. We have human waste that's turned into logs for fuel. We even have a soap made out of urine. This is a wonderful work by artist Rosalyn Fisher, The Topography of Tears. The artist collected tears, different kinds of tears of compassion and joy, and uses a microscope to photograph the crystallized forms. It's wonderful to imagine the causes of the different tears here. Apparently they even include cutting onions. These photographs by Tom Hagen show the impact of industry on the landscape. On the left, you have greenhouses growing fruit and vegetables in Almeria in Spain. They're 30 times as productive as an average European farm, but a huge cost to the local water environment, draining the aquifer. On the right, you have lithium in Chile, where it's collected from the salt brine to feed the global thirst for electronics and electric vehicles. agriculture and industry are by far the most reckless abusers of water. Over 70% of the world's fresh water is used to grow crops and raise livestock. This rather wonderful object by Studio Biosine is a prototype for part of a building facade. The rainwater runs down this dramatic pipe and is over algae, which clean the grey wastewater so that it can be collected and reused to water plants. The dry city is one of the most frightening spectres to haunt the 21st century, but it's a very real prospect since Cape Town faced day zero, the day when the taps run dry in 2017. Many of the ideas gathered here look at ways to live with water rather than try and control it. Humans have long tried to control and harness water, straightening rivers, damming rivers, cutting down rainforest for farmland, draining wetlands. But these interventions have come at huge environmental and human cost. Here we bring together new approaches that look at ways to work with water and nature rather than against it, to restore balance between humans and the natural world. This work is called Eden in Iraq. It's a design for a wastewater garden in the Mesopotamian marshes where plants are used to purify wastewater. The design of the garden that we see here is based on a traditional textile from the region, and we have an example of a wedding shawl here. This mural is a commission for the water pressure exhibition by Ooze Architects called Reimagine Water Flows. It looks at the water issues in this region from the scale of a building, the MK&G Museum, the city of Hamburg, and the Elbe Water Basin, and how these three scales are interconnected. Here we have two extraordinary drawings of the museum building. First of all, we see its current linear systems where rain comes out of the sky, washes through the building and out into the city's drainage system, essentially a linear system. And this is a proposal for a green and blue space, turning the museum into a green and blue free space where the water is captured and re-cleaned using bioswales and plants on the site and surrounding the museum. So the museum, instead of using and discharging water, captures it, cleans it, and can even contribute to the local water environment.